So this is Steve Mould.
Hello.
And we've just made a video about internet sensation 2048, the game. And that's on Steve's channel. Steve the Brave?
It is called Steve and the Brave with a B. Because I set it up ages ago and you know.
What a stupid name for a channel. You should have a sensible name like I've got.
Like Singing Banana.
go see Steve and I's video. We'll put annotations somewhere. But we thought we'd do a little extra bit. Some extra bit of mathsy things, which will be on my channel. Because we're going to do some proof by induction.
A bit of proof by induction. My favourite.
Excellent. So in the full video, we were talking about the score that each tile in 2048 can make. Maybe I'll do this quickly if you haven't seen this. If I joined, look, I've got all these props now. I join two tiles together, they merge, they create a four tile, which I haven't got somewhere nearby. A four tile, you get 4 points for that. And we were talking about, you know, how many points would you get for something like a 16 tile? To make a 16 tile, you need a pair of eights. To make an eight, you need a pair of fours, and for a point, four, you need a pair of twos, right?
Yeah.
And so in the full video, though, we described it as a big pyramid.
Yes.
So the 16 would be at the top, next big pyramid, all the twos, then eight, two tiles at the bottom, and it all accumulates up, and all their score adds up and makes the 16 tile, right? And the pyramid, if I did it in general, the pyramid would have K levels.
K levels, yeah.
The apex would be 2 to the K.
Yeah.
That's my general tile. K levels, and each level would add up to 2 to the K.
2 to the K, all right.
Right? So the formula, right, that I worked out is if you want to make 2 to the K, you score altogether K minus 1 lots of 2 to the K. So this pyramid you make, each level scores 2 to the K. And this K to the minus 1 levels, the bottom level wouldn't count. You get those for free.
Right.
Now, proof by induction, because there's a nice... Is that formula really true? Is it true in general? So to do this in general, if I have... Great. A 2 to the K tile.
Yeah.
And another 2 to the K tile, they would then join and merge and
two
make...
2 to the K plus 1.
2 to the K plus 1. Exactly. So, this one, like I said, scores k minus 1 times 2 to the k. This one scores the same. I'll try and draw that in. Oh, this is really difficult to do.
We said no second takes allowed.
No second takes allowed.
This is raw. Raw
man alive. Do you know what? It's more difficult to write this at a 37 degree angle than it is upside down. Right, 2 to the k. Then we would merge them, and when you merge them, you make this one. Which means you, for this one, you get 2 to the k plus 1 points.
Right.
So I'm going to add again.
Oh, yeah, so you've got these two that you've already got.
Yep.
You've got the scores for those.
So that's
and you're going to get a score for this one.
Then join them, and which adds on that.
It's k plus 1.
Here's your formula. So how much does this score altogether?
Well, yeah, so what do we expect to get?
Yeah, so apparently, well, if I add all this together, what I would expect with my formula.
Yeah.
My formula, what was it? It was the k minus 1 and 2 to the k. But now I'm using k plus 1 there.
So substituting k plus 1 for k.
Wherever I had it before, yeah. So it's the formula I expect to get
is,
and in fact I'm going to write it in.
Yeah.
What I expect to get is k times 2 to the k plus 1.
Right. So if these two things are equal, proof by induction.
Proof by induction, inductive step. And, well, let's cut the long story short. You do the sums there, which is not too hard. You've got two lots of this. So you can, this suddenly goes up a step to k plus 1. And then add on another 2 to the k plus 1. We'll get you k lots of 2 to the k plus 1. So it does work. The inductive step does work. The base case does work. We can check it out with the fours.
Yeah.
Boom.
Great.
Proof by induction.
Proof by induction, ladies
and
gentlemen.
Lovely job. There was another pre-planned
action. Yeah, there is another pre-planned action if you want to do it. This is like, what is the highest score you can get on a board? Oh, here we go. Okay, so
look,
we're going to...
I made two props. I'm going to use them both.
Where's that?
I made two props.
Right.
They're both the same. Yeah, so in the main video, we talked about the highest achievable tile.
Yeah.
In 2048. The aim of the game is to get 2048, but you can get further than that. And to get the highest achievable tile, well, basically, if you want to get 2 to the K, all these tiles are powers of 2.
Yeah.
So if you want to get 2 to the K, you need K tiles. Or okay. K3 cells, I'm sorry. You need K3 cells to do that. Just to make that point there, and I won't hammer this home, but let's do that. Let's play a game. This one curls. Make yourself useful.
Right. There you go.
So
I knew I was here for a reason.
Okay. So first of all, if I want to make a 4 tile, I need 2 of these 2 tiles, like that. And so I need 2 free cells so that I can put these 2s in, and then they would merge to make a 4 tile, like that. So the next thing I want to do is to make an 8 tile. So to do that, I'd swipe. Yeah, you'd generate a thing like that, you'd swipe again, you generate another one. But if you can see here, to make 8, which is 2 to the power 3, I do need 3 free cells.
Yeah. Okay.
So then I would merge them, that makes another 4, if I can get one, there you go. And then I would merge these 4s to get an 8. There you go. Lovely.
Right.
So the next tile up is 2 to the power 4, 16, to make that. Well, now I need to start... I need another 8, which means, let's cut this short, which means if I need to make another 8, I know I need 3 cells make another 8. So I can use these. I've got 3 free here, so I use those 3, and eventually I've created my another 8. But I had my 8 there occupying the 4th, just sitting there taking up that cell. So altogether, I did need to have 4 cells.
Yeah.
To finally join these 8s together and get my 16 tile. Now that's going to happen as you keep going up.
Yeah.
You're going to need K cells to make 2 to the power K.
But so to be clear, you needed 4 free cells to make this 16. So now if you wanted to make another 16, you couldn't do it because you've only got 3 free cells.
Exactly. Okay. Yeah, I need 4 to make another 16. I've got 3 left.
Okay.
Exactly. So in the full video, we've said it, but I'll just say that point again. In the full game, the 4x4 grid is 16 cells. So in theory, if everything goes your way and everything lands where you need it to be, you could, hypothetically, get 2 to the power 16.
Okay.
Which is 65,000 something.
Something like that. 65,000.
And that's pretty much an inductive argument again.
Yeah.
The number of free cells you need do need to be in the right sort of positions. They can't just be in a row. That doesn't work. Not the way the game works when you swipe.
Oh yeah, of course, yeah.
But I think it works perfectly well in a.
You can prove it probably going from like a 2x2 to a 3x3 to a 4x4.
I think there's clearly an inductive argument, and I haven't crossed the T's and dot the I's here, but I think there is.
I mean, Fermat said a very similar thing.
We have a perfectly marvellous demonstration of the inductive argument, which this video is too short to contain. And if you have been, thanks for watching.